Cassandra Borg, a troubled 17-year-old, is being interrogated by police regarding the violent murder of her grandparents. As the detectives uncover the truth, they realize Cassandra is a heartless serial killer. Despite their efforts to engage her in casual conversation, Cassandra remains detached. She reflects on her troubled past, including frequent police calls and assaulting her grandmother, before meeting Johnny Ryder, whom she convinces to help kill her grandparents. The detectives try to make Cassandra comfortable, discussing her hobbies and laughing at jokes, before delving into the reason for her interrogation. They revisit previous conversations and ask follow-up questions, attempting to gather more information without causing distress. Cassandra reveals that she and Johnny had been together for about 3 months and expresses her lingering feelings for him despite their current situation. She recounts a moment when Johnny expressed his love for her, describing seeing only her surrounded by purple, a sign of love to him. However, she also mentions Johnny's tumultuous past relationship, indicating that his ex accuses her of stalking, although they've only met twice. The detectives inquire about Johnny's well-being and learn that he attempted suicide with Cassandra before they were caught by SWAT. Both were saved by the police and hospitalized. After extensive medical treatment, Cassandra was discharged and taken to the police station. She begins recounting the events, starting from when she was kicked out by her grandmother, rather than running away. After returning home on the night of either the 31st or 28th, and Cassandra describes how her argument with her grandmother led to her leaving home and staying with Johnny, sleeping in his car. The detectives inquire about her social circle, including her friends Sabrina and Ezzie. They ask about her return to her grandparents' house, which happened a couple of days later. Though Cassandra doesn't recall the exact date, she recounts a conversation with Johnny at PE Church Park, where he initially brought up the idea of running away together and asked if she would be willing to kill her grandparents. She hesitated but eventually agreed, expressing her desire to escape her troubled family situation and strained relationship with her grandparents, which worsened after she got into legal trouble for assaulting them. Cassandra reflects on how her grandparents' treatment of her changed over time, causing her to feel alienated and disconnected. Despite her earlier positive experiences with them, the age gap and her troubled past contributed to a growing divide. When asked about the specifics of the plan, Cassandra indicates that Johnny discussed it at the park, but doesn't provide details. Cassandra details how she and Johnny accessed her grandparents' home through the back door using keys she already had. They waited outside until her grandmother turned off the lights, then entered through the unlocked door on the right side of the back deck, bypassing the alarm system by removing its battery. Cassandra managed to move items blocking the door without making noise, allowing Johnny to enter. Once inside, they listened for any signs of activity before proceeding upstairs. Cassandra carried a tire iron from Johnny's car, while Johnny brought a black backpack. They planned to carry out their sinister intentions using these items. Cassandra continues her chilling account, describing how she and Johnny wore gloves and used a tire iron from his car to enter her grandparents' home. She reveals how they divided their roles, with Johnny confronting her grandfather while she attacked her grandmother, using the tire iron to deliver the fatal blow. They duct-taped her grandmother's hands, head, and ankles to restrain her. Cassandra then recounts retrieving knives from the kitchen and a code to her grandmother's safe, where they found $1,000 in cash. Afterward, they moved her grandmother to the bathroom and checked to ensure both grandparents were dead before leaving. They spent the next few days living in the house, going about their normal activities while concealing the bodies. Eventually, they discussed plans to murder Johnny's family. Cassandra describes how the plan to target Johnny's family emerged after they killed her grandparents. They initially stayed in town with intentions to attack both of their families, but their plan to target Johnny's family did not unfold as expected. They attempted to incapacitate Johnny's sister and her boyfriend with bear repellent spray, but encountered difficulties. The conversation then delves into Cassandra's feelings about her actions, revealing her strained relationship with her grandparents, particularly her grandmother. While she expresses remorse and acknowledges the complexity of her emotions, she also expresses a desire to escape her family situation. When asked if her mother was part of the plan to kill them, Cassandra's response is unclear. Cassandra explains that she and Johnny discussed the plan to target both of their families, but Johnny ultimately dismissed the idea of targeting his own family. However, Cassandra still harbored the desire to get away from her family, which was a driving factor behind her actions. She describes feeling a rush of emotions during the attack on her grandparents, including anger, sadness, and a sense of heartbreak. Despite her martial arts training, she struggled to control her emotions at the moment. She also mentions that her probation restrictions added to her frustration and contributed to her desire to escape her family situation. Finally, she confirms that they used her grandmother's credit card during the week between the murders, and that they were smoking weed during that time. Cassandra describes that Johnny's relationship with his family was strained, particularly with his mother, who would often criticize him. This suggests that Johnny's motives for targeting his family may have been influenced by familial conflict and potential financial gain. The conversation between Cassandra and the detectives becomes tense, as they confront her about the evidence indicating that she hosted parties at her grandparents' house after their murders, despite her initial denial. The detectives emphasize the importance of honesty in their investigation and express their frustration with Cassandra's attempts to downplay the situation. They confront her with evidence suggesting that Sunshine and her boyfriend Alex were at the house during that time. Despite Cassandra's reluctance to admit the truth, the detectives continue to press her for more accurate information about what occurred. They challenge her to explain why she would protect those individuals and not disclose their presence at the house, highlighting the seriousness of the situation. Using the same bleach bottle, you bleach Grandpa first, then Grandma, and then discard the bottle in the trash can in the bathroom. Let me, it's more like a Windex bottle than a tub of bleach in Johnny. The doors were bleached and killed several days later due to a smelly situation. We didn't expect to have guests over, only Sunshine. Alex came over one day, thinking it would be fine since only a few days had passed. They were unaware that your grandparents were upstairs. I told them that they were on vacation. Did they go upstairs at all? No. How long did they stay there for? Just for like a few hours. They came really late at night. Who else came over? It was just Sunshine. You said we only thought Sunshine and Alex were coming, that was it. Was just them. No one else came to the house. What the detectives find interesting is how easily Cassandra was able to lie about having people over. It wasn't until they showed her evidence that she was lying that she finally told the truth. If lying is that easy for Cassandra, what else is she lying about? As I stated before, the police would eventually find out that Cassandra was a mastermind behind the murders, and if she had her way, there would have been 7 bodies instead of 2. Okay, let me ask you this then. You literally have shown no emotion towards your grandparents, and I know how problem. Like, I don't know the life that you were having, and I guess I can kind of understand that you wanted to sever that part of your life and start over again. I'm not sure why you're showing emotion when I mentioned Sunshine. She's a close friend who was there during my parents' struggles, but not as close as Izzy. Izzy didn't know what happened, and I told everyone about it. Yes, you pretended to be Grandma and texted Saya, a family member in California. You texted Sylvia, asking if she was okay. She started freaking out, and I responded by saying everything was fine. Did you take Grandma's phone from her nightstand? Please share your thoughts on who you think was involved in this case. Johnny or Cassandra was the mastermind. I'll put these in your bag. Regarding your prints and swabs, I need to get a search warrant. Do you understand? Obtaining a search warrant was necessary to take your fingerprints, swab, and photos. You were accused of 2 counts of EG assault for the incident at Johnny's place, as is Johnny. You were being charged with malice murder for your grandmother and grandfather. I am a straight shooter and will inform you of the charges. If you have any questions, please let me know.